This is a Domino's pizza. And this is everything that goes into making it. Welcome to Fast Food Chemistry. I wanted to know just what goes into the most popular pizza on the planet. So I was able to get a hold of the 56 ingredients that go into making one and build it myself. But don't try this at home.
All right, we're back again with another Fast Food Chemistry. And honestly, I haven't watched any of this yet, but I kind of feel like this one's gonna be a lot harder than the Big Mac, specifically because, to my knowledge, there's a fly in the studio, to my knowledge, the studio in New York does not have a pizza oven. I've never worked at a Domino's, but I have worked at a few pizza places. Good luck, Metha.
This bottle is phosphoric acid. It's used as an acidifier and a preservative that inhibits mold growth. It's also commonly found in sugary sodas. We left an egg in the phosphoric acid for days, and the result is this. It looks like the shell has completely dissolved and what's left over is just the membrane of the egg. To illustrate what this stuff can do to your teeth, we put a real wisdom tooth in phosphoric acid. After just a few days, the tooth completely dissolved.
Sorry, where are you guys getting teeth?
This is L-cysteine, which recent studies have shown could be effective in combating hangovers.
Can confirm, does work, it's great. The problem is you need to remember to take the L-cysteine while you're drinking. Good luck with that.
Then there's TBHQ, found in the garlic oil. It's pretty dangerous, and we couldn't get our hands on it.
Domino's pizza sauce contains tomato puree, which is water and tomato paste, sugar, salt, spices, garlic, soybean oil, and citric acid.
From that group of ingredients, we don't really see anything surprising. The only quote-unquote chemical is citric acid, which is what gives citrus fruits their characteristic sour taste. As a food additive, it's the thing that makes sour candy like Warhead sour, so it's probably a little more sour than you would expect.
Do a little citric acid taste test?
This is the citric acid.
I don't even know how much is like too much. That's too much! Yeah! Yo! A little goes a long way. Domino's hand-tossed dough contains enriched flour, which is wheat flour, iron, thiamine mononitrate, niacin, riboflavin, folic acid, water, soybean oil, and contains 2% or less of the following: sugar, salt, whey, maltodextrin, dextrose, dough conditioners, which is sodium stearyl acetate, enzyme, calcium sulfate, sorbic acid, calcium phosphate, L-cysteine, yeast, and cornmeal used in preparation.
The base of this dough is the same as most. It has enriched flour, sugar, salt, water, and yeast. After that, the ingredients for the dough start to get interesting. Maltodextrin and dextrose are both sweeteners, kind of like sugar. The dough conditioners are a few ingredients that create chemical reactions to do two things: improve consistency and speed up the cooking process. They are sodium stearyl lactate, aka SSL, an emulsifier that gives the dough a springier texture. You can think of also an emulsifier as a substance that helps two otherwise incompatible substances, like oil and water, bind together. Amylase is the enzyme that's naturally found in your saliva to digest food. Putting it in the dough does a similar thing. It breaks down the sugars and converts them to carbon dioxide, helping the dough rise. Finally, L-cysteine. This is a dough strengthener. The FDA categorizes L-cysteine as GRAS, generally recognized as safe. But they regulate that it can only make up 0.009% of the recipe, which is a little bit fishy. L-cysteine can be typically made from goose or duck feathers and or pig hairs and hooves, but Domino's says theirs is not animal-derived. Vegan L-cysteine is derived from E. coli.
What? So the choice is L-cysteine from animals or L-cysteine from E. coli.
These doughs have finally risen. I can see what the ingredients are doing. It's softer and it's holding its shape.
It's a surprise to me that how good it actually looks, considering that it has all those chemicals, and I would assume that it was harder to put together. So yeah, so far so good. Domino's calls their cheese pizza cheese, and it contains part skim mozzarella cheese, which is pasteurized milk, cultures, salts, enzymes, modified food starch, cellulose added to prevent caking, non-fat milk, whey protein concentrate, natural flavors, sodium, propionate, added as a preservative.
All these enzymes in the cheese aren't the same as the enzyme in the dough. Instead, it's rennet, a substance used to separate milk into solid curds. Typically, rennet is made from the stomach lining of ruminant mammals, such as calves and buffalo, but Domino says that the rennet they use is not derived from animals, meaning their cheese is both vegetarian and halal. A little mozzarella bowl, it's perfect. So, now that we've shredded our mozzarella cheese, we're gonna toss it in modified food starch and cellulose to prevent it from caking together. Cellulose is a dietary plant fiber, and one of the most common sources is wood pulp.
The cheese that Domino's and most other fast food pizza places use is low moisture part skim mozzarella. The lower fat content means it doesn't get as oily when it melts, and the lower moisture content means it melts more consistently. I've got low moisture mozzarella cheese right here, alongside the fresh stuff. Can I make it any clearer? They're different.
This is definitely thicker, still really smooth than this guy. Creamier, but also grittier? Does that make sense?
Domino's ingredients are thorough enough that they even include their pan spray. It contains water, propellant, soybean oil, soy lecithin, potassium sorbate, preservative, and sorbic acid, also preservative.
Soy lecithin is in everything from ice cream to baby formula. The color of soy lecithin is not what you'd expect. It's like an orange color. Depending on what study you listen to, it'll lower your cholesterol or it can kill you. Then we have two preservatives, potassium sorbate and sorbic acid. Sorbic acid is a naturally occurring compound, and today it's the most commonly used preservative in the world. It's not an exaggeration to say the global food supply chain wouldn't be possible without it. It's an effective antifungal agent. There is a propellant added into the pan spray too, which is a pressurized liquid that rapidly turns into gas when exposed to air. When you press the nozzle on a spray can, this is what causes the contents to spray out. There's no way of telling which propellant Domino's uses, since the FDA evidently doesn't require companies to disclose it. But propellants approved for food use in the US include carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, food-safe alcohols, and even petroleum-derived fuels like propane and butane. This would be incredibly dangerous to replicate in the studio, so I'm actually gonna ignore that one. I'm not trying to have explosives in the office, and I'm not trying to blow my hands off. Instead, I'm gonna mix it all into a little spray bottle right here.
After hearing all that, she's shaking it up. It's like, don't explode. Domino's adds a garlic oil blend to the crust after baking to make it extra savory and addicting. It contains the following: butter-flavored oil, which is liquid and hydrogenated soybean oil, palm oil, salt, natural flavors, which contains canola oil, lipolyzed butter oil, sunflower and soy lecithin, lactic acid, colored with generic and beta-carotene, artificial flavor, THQ and citric acid, protects flavor, vitamin A, palmitate, unalized yeast extract, beta-carotene for color, dehydrated garlic, parmesan cheese, which is part skim milk, cheese cultures, salt and enzymes, salt, dehydrated parsley, spice, and extract for color, natural flavors, citric acid, lactic acid, and oleoresin rosemary.
The main ingredient is butter-flavored oil, which is essentially soybean and palm oil with artificial flavoring and preservatives. Stay straight.
Oh, God. Yeah, it tastes kind of like butter, but it tastes like butter-flavored something.
TBHQ and citric acid are added to protect flavor and extend shelf life. However, TBHQ is regulated by the FDA and can only be used in small doses due to evidence that large quantities may be harmful. One study found that TBHQ increased the incidence of tumors in rats, while another study reported cases of vision disturbances in humans.
TBHQ gets the JDFWI. Joe doesn't f with it.
I tried to buy it, but at every turn, each supplier asked me if I was a registered laboratory, which, as y'all can see, I clearly am not. So that is one ingredient we weren't able to get our hands on, but I'm high-key relieved.
Putting the stuff together, putting the stuff together.
Then we add some chefy things like Parmesan, salt, parsley, spices, and of course, garlic. I'm the biggest fan of garlic. Like, I don't care if, like, I'm about to, you know, smooch people or... Sorry, not people, my husband.
Good save.
That's pretty good.
The Domino's Buttermilk Ranch sauce contains soybean oil, cultured buttermilk, distilled vinegar, water, high fructose corn syrup, sour cream, which is cultured cream, contains less than 2% of sugar, salt, egg yolk, whey protein concentrate, garlic juice, garlic powder, monosodium glutamate, xanthan gum, onion, polysorbate 60, parsley, calcium sorbate, and sodium benzoate preservatives. Cream, natural flavor, phosphoric acid, spice, lactic acid, calcium disodium, EDTA to protect the flavor, blue cheese, pasteurized milk, cheese cultures, salt, enzymes, whey powder, non-fat milk.
Oh, the asterisk. It's dried.
You've almost definitely heard of high fructose corn syrup. In the US, it's used as a sweetener in tons of processed foods, including some where you might not expect to find it, like this ranch sauce right here. It's not the same as the corn syrup you can buy in the grocery store. And in fact, it's pretty difficult to get your hands on if you're not a food manufacturer. However, I did manage to buy some, and it's right here. Oh my God. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm not allowed to say that. Holy moly. All right, guys, can someone help me, please? Okay. So the funny thing about our buddy right here is that we only need like a quarter cup of high fructose corn syrup, but because restaurants and stuff or food manufacturers need this stuff in bulk, it comes in this huge bucket. Then we have sour cream, sugar, salt, egg yolk, which are all normal so far.
Yo, you should use that egg that you dissolved the shell from. That would have been funny. Remember that? I do, because it was terrifying.
Then there's xanthan gum, which acts as a thickener. You may remember this as a component of the thick water in our last episode of Fast Food Chemistry.
You know I didn't forget. Thick water. It's like water, but weird.
Polysorbate 60, also called Tween 60, is used as an emulsifier that helps water-based and oil-based ingredients blend easily and prevent their separation in food. Its other main purpose is a solubilizer and surfactant in cosmetic items like makeup and lotion. There's preservatives, potassium sorbate, and sodium benzoate. Sodium benzoate inhibits the growth of microorganisms, but it's also used in a mixture that makes fireworks whistle. Luckily for us, it's not the explosive part of that mixture, which I'm 100% glad because that would be horrifying, yet it is another GRAS additive. And then we have calcium disodium EDTA. What does EDTA stand for, you're wondering? It's ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. Calcium disodium EDTA is actually used as a medicine to treat lead and plutonium poisoning.
Calcium disodium EDTA is a chemical used in the film Blade to kill vampires. What? We could not independently verify the effectiveness against the undead, so we'll go ahead and take the screenwriter's word for it. Or will we, Connor? Yeah! Eat the sauce if you've been exposed to nuclear waste, but not if you're a vampire.
And then finally, we have blue cheese, even more whey protein and milk. So we got our pan spray here, and we're gonna spray this pan. And then over here, we're gonna add some cornmeal to start leveling out the dough.
Come on, flip with your get in there, get in there.
I'm transporting you to the Domino headquarters. We are there making pizza for all our friends. And I just don't want to poison them with all these chemicals. All right, pizza will go into the oven.
I don't know about that oven. I don't know, it just looks like, who knows? How hot could that oven get?
All right, whoa, look at that. Holy moly. Let's slice it. This looks phenomenal.
Yeah, I mean, that looks like a pizza. I don't know if it looks like a Domino's pizza. We're missing a slice for some weird reason. Yeah! I'm surprised. I mean, that looks a lot better than I thought it was going to be.
Like every Domino's pizza, they have a garlic crust, so we gotta add the beautiful garlic sauce.
That looks like Domino's pizza.
This literally looks like Domino's pizza.
Literally? I mean, it looks like a pizza.
This is our pizza, and this is Domino's pizza. And I have to say, I'm incredibly surprised. I'm pretty sure we could fool people into thinking this was the pizza that came out of the box.
If that pizza showed up, I'd be like, something's wrong.
It's the moment of truth. We're gonna try our pizza.
This is a pretty good pizza.
This part I'm really interested in finding out if we did a good job, which is the garlic part. Okay, so this is the Domino's pizza. Here you go. So as you can tell from the back of the pizza, like I said, ours could have taken a little more heat.
Because you didn't have the crust exposed to the heat because you had it on that pan.
But I think this one is just, you can taste the garlic and it overpowers everything else. And that's the one thing that's missing. Now we gotta compare the ranches. So right here, I have our ranch. Let's try theirs. Right, this is their ranch sauce. Honestly, they're not that different. I think we did a really good job with the Buttermilk Ranch sauce.
So for me watching this, everything up until cooking, the execution was perfect. I would have given her an A. All the differences, as someone who made pizzas professionally for longer than he cares to admit, would say that the cook of the pizza, it being on a pan with no holes and being in that tabletop oven, you're just not gonna get the same kind of consistent cook. So, but those things is just we learn from, I'm assuming she has now worked in a pizzeria and also comes from making a pizza in an office and not a kitchen. Considering Metha's limitations, I'll give her an A-. I bet it tastes great. All right, I'm done. Who would like to have a slice of pizza with me?